of all, a podcast takes a lot of work, okay? You have to organize the guests, you have to do a Google Calendar, and you build a following. It takes a long fucking time, and I've been working on it for a while.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back or welcome to the podcast. I'm Alexi DiStefano. This is I Don't Care the podcast. And today we have Hewat on FaceTime. She didn't know I was. You have been bamboozled.
I've been safe in my own home.
No, I got you. I got her. She didn't know we were going to podcast right now, but I said, hey, I'm down here. An episode needs to come out in the morning. And he was on FaceTime. So, you were saying something about Rachel?
Yeah, I love that girl.
From the Hunger Games. Oh. I accidentally hung up on Hewat. Wait, my phone died. Oh my god, this timing, everybody. Okay, well, she's laughing in her boots right now. I can just feel it in my gut. Right before I press record, Luna just did a full piss on the floor, which she's not done in a long time. I'm very disappointed in her. I'm just wondering, if my phone died, maybe this isn't working. So actually, everyone, hold on to your pants, because I've got to find a new thing. What a mess. Okay. Oh, I'm FaceTiming my mom. I don't know why I was just FaceTiming my mom. Guys. Okay. That was strange. This is a mess so far. This is a great old mess so far. We're just trying to get Hewat back on.
I'm back.
Oh, I don't see you. I see my face.
Oh, well, I'm here. I see you.
Okay, well, I see me and I hear you. And my phone died. So the wall plug I put in the wall, I forgot was a broken one. Wasn't charging my phone. But I had another one beside me, so I plugged that one in. But that was so stressful. And then somehow I accidentally FaceTimed my mom.
Oh.
Trying to FaceTime you.
Oh.
So, we're back. I still don't see you.
I see normal. I see you and me, so I don't know what I can do to help with that.
Okay, let me turn my camera off and see if I turn it back on, if I see you. You see? No. Well, I guess I'll just hold you up here anyway, so you're by the mic. So before my phone died, what were you saying?
I was saying that I love me some Rachel Zegler. And you know what? I feel like so bad for this girl.
Me too.
Because she just gets so much
hate. So much hate.
It's absurd, and I want to say, I've been saying this since the start.
No, I've been saying it from the start, too. I don't know if I've been saying it to you, but I feel like I have.
I don't think we've ever spoken about her, but I fully believe that you've been saying it from the start.
I have. I've been saying it to Cassie, for sure.
Let me start from the beginning.
Yeah, please do.
Let me start, not talk about her hate. Let me just talk about her for a sec.
Okay.
Because she deserves to just get a recognition for being who she is.
Hey, and I don't care.
Just, like, out and about on YouTube or something. I don't know. I think she was just, like, she's always been a Broadway girly, and she's just been, like, singing her little heart out on YouTube and stuff before mm-hmm. she booked anything. First thing she ever booked, Steven Spielberg's West Side Story as Maria, the female lead. First thing she's ever booked.
Insanity. Good for her.
I saw it in theater. Amazing movie. She did absolutely amazing. She has a beautiful voice. She's stunning. She's a great actress. Rah. I'm pretty sure that, I don't know if that movie got nominated for an Oscar, but I know that one of the other female leads won an Oscar for it. So, like, the movie was in the Oscar, like, lexicon.
Right.
And I remember when it happened, I'm pretty sure, like, since the movie was nominated for stuff, like, obviously people were going, but they didn't invite her. And, like, I remember, right? And I remember, like, I think she went on Twitter or something and, like, talked about it, or, like, she spoke out, like, why am I not being invited when she was the female lead of this movie and it's getting nominated for things.
Oh,
and
I'd be pissed.
I think she did end up getting an invite or something. I can't really remember. I don't remember all the details because at the time I didn't really know who she was. But I do remember that people were hating on her for that. And they were like, she's so entitled, da 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 da. Like,
whatever. No, because those same people saying she's so entitled do shit for their life. Like, if you were the lead of a movie that is winning Oscars and you aren't invited, you'd be so pissed.
And you're inviting my castmates, but you're not inviting me. Like, I just feel like, why would you not invite her? You know what I mean? That's just so odd. And I don't know, like, all the details of the story, so I might be getting something wrong. But I know that what I said is kind of the truth. And I do remember people, like, getting upset at her. And I don't think it was a huge thing, but, like, people were definitely hating on her. And it probably was huge for her, because that was her first movie, you know? And people are, like, hating on you for just speaking up about not getting an invitation for something that, like, anyone should get an invitation for. Anyways.
Yeah.
And that's so stupid, because she fucking killed it. Why wouldn't they invite her? Whatever. And then the next thing she books is Shazam.
Mm.
Which is, like, a superhero movie or something.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't watch it, but I remember she was on the red carpet for it, and someone asked her, why did you choose this project or something, something? And she goes, I needed a job.
Yes.
And this came and da-da-da-da. And I remember when I saw that, I said, she is so fucking real for that.
Yes.
She's so real. She is so funny because that is just fact. I never understood why people ask that question on red carpets.
As if you actually chose.
DiCaprio. Like, we're not all choosing projects, you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
And she was like, oh, I just need a job. I've only done one thing. Like,
what do you mean? I got the audition. I booked the audition. I did the job. Got the money. And now I'm here.
And she wasn't saying, like, she hated it. She goes on to say that she's so happy and it was a great experience and whatever. But she just, like, made a little fun, lighthearted joke and said something that was, like, period facts.
Mm-hmm.
And then it got so blown up. Oh, my God. I can't even really deal with this. It got so blown up. I was watching people talking about it on daytime TV. Like, everyone was saying, debating back and forth on, like, whether or not she was being a bitch and being bratty and being entitled and not grateful. Are we even living on the same planet right now? Like, what are you talking?
Like, I'm sorry. Do you go to work every single day and not just say 1,000 times in your head, it's for the money, it's for the money, it's for the money, it's for the money, stick it out, it's for the money? Like, we all do it. Like, I'm sorry, just people are so mean to her for no reason. It pisses me off.
And this is only the second thing she's ever booked.
I know.
And you're getting wrong. Like, you're telling me you've only booked two things and it's West Side Story and Shazam?
Mm-hmm.
And your franchise? Okay, girl. Yeah, you're in your bag. You're
yep.
in your bag. Like, all these haters are just haters because you're in your bag. Like, she's just
killing it.
Thing.
Mm-hmm.
And then the next thing she books.
Oh, man.
Snow fucking White. This mm-hmm. bitch is playing
Snow White.
And I, hey, couldn't be happier for her. Love.
She's perfect. She looks perfect.
A fucking princess.
She's perfect.
That's the third thing you've ever booked, bitch. Get out of my face with that shit. And then everyone wants to jump down her fucking throat.
Mm-hmm.
This is, like, some of the worst hate I've ever seen for something so stupid. All she said was that the movie creeped her out when she was younger, and it's, like, not the best message if you really think about it. And then she goes on to praise the project and praise the new version of it and what everyone's doing, and she's so grateful and so kind.
Exactly. Okay, you cut out, so I'll talk. But, because I'll talk until you're not cut out anymore. But also, like, the fact that, you know, she was saying stuff like, this is the modern version of Snow White, and this is the updated version without, like, the misogyny. Why are people so pressed about that? If you don't like the changes, just watch the original. Don't watch the new one.
And she didn't write it.
She didn't write it.
She simply did not write the script. She actually didn't make the story. All she did was book the role and mm-hmm. play it. What would you rather her do? Would you rather her shit on the thing that she actually filmed and made and the version that is being put out with her face attached to it and praise the original version? Why would she do that? Why would she do that? Talk crazy shit on the original version. All she said was, like, kind of weird, right? That she needed a man and da 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 da. All she said was, which is just, like, I feel like we're moving the goalpost. Because when the discourse first started after her interviews, everyone was saying, I just hate that we're all like feminist this, feminist that. But you know what, ladies? It's okay to actually want a man, and it's okay to actually. Who said it wasn't? How was she supposed to know that suddenly it's problematic to be a feminist? What the hell? Like what?
like she's this bad person because she's a feminist now?
Ridiculous. And she didn't even say anything bad. Like, for people to say, well, it's like it was her tone. No, it wasn't. Nothing was wrong with what she said at all.
All right. Sorry. To all these technical difficulties. I didn't want to edit, but here we are. Okay, Hiwat. Pop off.
Okay. I was just saying that I think that at minimum, half of the hate that she's getting over all the Snow White stuff is just because people are so racist and they're so upset that a Latino woman is playing Snow White and she is not pale as a fucking ghost, and instead she has like a slight olive tone on her skin. Maybe they filmed this in the winter and she's very light. I remember she was quite light in West Side Story. And even if, it doesn't really matter.
Doesn't fucking matter.
Her parents are pretty light too. Like, she's not like, who cares? Like, it really doesn't matter. And people are just like, they just want to be racist, and they just hate that people of color are getting any opportunities or taking away opportunities that would have gone to a white person. And I'm sick of seeing it. I feel so bad for this girl. The discourse went so crazy. Like, it's actually insane. It's insane how much hate she gets. Like, really, really it is. And now she's come out with, oh my God, I'm actually sick. Like, as much as I love her and will defend her with everything in me, a part of me hates her because I am so jealous.
Right? You know,
she's lead. She's playing Lucy Gray in The Hunger Games, Battle of Songbirds and Snakes, which I just watched, and it was so fucking good, and she was so fucking good. And she sang so much in it, and it sounded beautiful, and I hate her because she can sing well so good, too. And, yeah, and that's the fourth thing she's done. That's four things. Let's recap. First, Steven Spielberg's West Side Story. Second, Shazam. Third, Snow White. And fourth, The Hunger Games. it makes me physically ill how successful and talented this girl is. Talented coming out of her fucking ass. These bitches wish that they could do what she's doing. I am these bitches. I'm part of that. And all the hate is so unjustified. Like, I just feel so, so, so bad for her.
I do too. I think it's insane that someone so beautiful, so talented, so smart, because honestly, the things she says, like, people twist them, but she's not saying anything dumb or stupid. And she's getting all this hate. This poor girl. Like, she can't be, what, more than 23 years old?
I'm pretty sure she's 22, maybe 21 even.
Exactly. Like, she's young. She is innocent because she's done nothing wrong. People, dumb assholes, twist the things she say to add like some context that doesn't even exist. Mm-hmm. And it's just dumb. Like, this poor girl has done four movies. She's been so successful. From movie number one, she, for some reason, has been an outcast, and the world continues to pin her down. And you what? You know what she continues to do? She continues to show up, be talented, say, fuck you, I don't care what you guys have to say about me, because I am successful, and she puts you all in her place, or in your places.
Mm-hmm.
And good for her. Huh?
She's just booked and busy and in her bag.
She doesn't have time to care about what everyone is saying about her.
The thing I feel the most bad for, like, really, this makes me feel like this breaks my heart, is that, like, watching her career, like, as actors, I see it and I'm just like, wow. Like, good for you. You're really, like, you're living the dream.
Yes.
Like, the actual dream.
The real dream.
Such diverse, amazing, like, high roles. That most people could even dream of playing one of them in their life. And, like, you're forming the career that most people wish they could have in their lifetime in the first beginnings of your career.
Of course.
You're so amazing. You're so fucking talented. You're so talented. Mm. She's literally so talented. And it just makes me sick that if this feels like if it was anyone else, they would be the it girl right now. It would be going to the Met Gala. Everyone would be following them. Everyone would love them. She would be the people's princess. But for whatever reason, all she's getting is hate since the very beginning. So she can't even really be happy and really like experience all the success and greatness because she's always dodging daggers like from every direction. And it's just so unfair to deal with at the beginning of your career when she should be like really understanding like how precious this is and like how amazing these opportunities are and get to feel like her accomplishments. But she doesn't even get to do that because everyone is hating on her for no reason, no matter what
but
she does.
You know what I will say that makes me respect her more than I already do is that you never see in interviews and stuff that the hate gets to her. She never changes herself because of the hate. She still says the things she wants to say. Her personality is still quirky and she's still herself. Like, she doesn't let the stupid haters get to her. And you can tell in the interviews, and I'm sure they do bother her because they fucking bother me and I'm not her.
Right. It's a lot. Like, you can only ignore hate so much.
Mm-hmm. But she doesn't let it change her. And that's great. She's strong. Add strong on top of the list. Yeah.
Like, number one fan club. We love Rachel
Zegler. Mm-hmm. Rachel, if you're watching, hey.
Come on the pod.
Come on the pod where we will not hate on you.
I hate a little bit, though, because I'm just so sick of her career.
I just envy her. We envy her.
I envy her so much. You don't understand. Like, every role she's played, I'm like, I would literally kill someone for that.
Yeah.
Kill someone for that. But I can also never play them because I can't sing. 3 out of 4 of her roles that she was singing, and I haven't seen Shazam. Maybe she sings in that too.
What songs are from Snow White?
I don't know, but surely there is songs.
No, because every Disney princess sings, but I can't recall a single song.
She's the one with the birds and the animals, right?
Yeah.
I don't know, let's look it up.
The birds and the animals, but not Cinderella. She's with the dwarves.
The dwarves, yeah.
But there's birds around too, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, they help her like get dressed and stuff, right?
Also, no, that's Cinderella.
Oh. I don't know.
Also, to me, she looks uncandid to Snow White.
Like, looks just like you mean?
Yes, like I don't understand why people are hating. Like, no one hated, for majority, nobody hated Halle Berry for...
It's Halle Bailey.
Halle Bailey. I knew because I was like, someone else.
Yeah, there was a different
Halle Yeah, Bailey. I was like, that's not right.
That's just not the case. I think Halle got 100 times more hate. Like,
did she? Okay, because I only saw love.
It's insane.
Okay,
I'm pretty sure if you go to like... It was either the trailer of The Little Mermaid or like the teaser trailer where she's like swimming up. But I remember when that got posted and I went and watched it. It had so many dislikes. It was crazy. I'm gonna look it up.
Okay, because I just remember watching all the videos of like people crying and being so touched. Maybe I just didn't get the other side of it. But there is no other side for Rachel.
Yeah, there's
it's just no you other. And I.
She ashes us. We're in the trenches here.
We're fighting for her.
We really are. Like, I just don't... And it really blows my mind, like, how many people hate. Because you know what? People are going to hate.
And I'm not, like, a fan. Like, I'm not, like, a fan who... I've never watched any of her things yet. But I respect her so much.
Yeah, After West Side Story... So that was her first thing, so obviously I didn't even know who she was. And I was like, period, she killed it. But, like... she didn't stand out to me personally, even though she'd be fucking amazing. The whole movie was just amazing, and everyone was really, really good. So she didn't stand out in particular to me. And then when I heard all that stuff, I was like, that's insane. People are literally out of their minds. And I didn't watch Shazam, but when I saw that interview, I was like, that's so funny. She's so real. And then when people were getting mad, I was like, what's going on here?
Yeah.
And Snow White, I honestly would not have even considered watching Snow White. At all, like, it doesn't interest me.
Yeah,
but now after everything that's happened, I absolutely will be seeing it. Just
in spite of all the haters, I'll be watching it. Yeah,
boycotted because of Palestine. But whatever. If everything works, besides, I stream everything illegally anyway. I'm not.
Yeah, we're not giving them money. We're not giving them money.
I wasn't gonna watch it, but I definitely will now. And the Hunger Games I didn't watch because of her. I watched because I wanted to watch it, and she steals the show. I love her.
Yeah. Like
the way she handles all this is just
beautiful. I just can't. There's many things in this world I don't understand, and the hate towards Rachel is one of them.
Yeah, 100%.
Were you looking something up?
Yeah, I was trying to look up that Little Mermaid trailer. But I have trouble seeing like dislikes on YouTube.
Oh, interesting. Well, speaking of Rachel's, did you see that Rachel Sennett is on like 30 under 30 for actors?
I did see that.
What an achievement.
What an achievement.
At least one Rachel is getting the respect they deserve.
Right. I love her.
Ah, man. Me too.
I love loving these. I love having all these people to love.
I know. It just hurts that like it's not a mutual thing.
It will be one day.
I know it will be one day, but it's lonely down here.
It is. It is lonely down here.
Yeah, we've got each other, but...
Yeah, no one else.
No one else. You think we'll get hate like that one day?
Maybe.
Because, like, that's a lot. Like, it's 10 times more than the average hate.
Yeah, I don't really... Hers is just so unwarranted. It's hard to, like, say that anyone could get hate like that, because they don't even see where it comes from, you know?
Yeah.
But... Surely we'll get hate.
I think me more than you, for sure.
Probably.
Yeah. I'm gonna get hate for, like, the most random things.
You kind of remind me of Rachel Zegler. The way that she talks in her interviews.
Yeah.
Like, that's how I could see you talking as well.
I think it stems from, like, she's genuinely excited and happy to be there.
Yeah, I think so, too. And I think she's just, like, gonna say what's on her mind.
And great. Which, hey, we already established, I love Rachel. I think she's great. I don't want the hate she's getting.
I don't want that for you either.
And if that's the trajectory it looks like I might be on, pray for me, everyone. I'm still going to do the thing, but pray for me. How's life been for you, Hiwat?
You know, it's been life been.
Well, no, because... The last they heard from you was before things happened with your vehicle. Oh, Hiwat's cutting out. What a cliffhanger. So I think last
maybe
time...
He has...
Huh? You cut out. What'd you say?
Fortunately, no longer. So Mandy has gone up to the car angels.
Yeah.
She's gone.
It's not. Yeah, we've lost not just my grandma recently. We lost Ewat's car, too.
And who's to say what's the bigger loss at the end of the day?
And who's to say? I was just thinking, like, yours was more of, like, a slow... you know, painful death, and my grandma's was a sudden tragedy.
That's so true.
And, you know, they're actually quite similar if we think about it.
If you think about it, they're kind of the same.
Kind of the same.
Maybe I should have a funeral for my car.
Do you want me to write a speech?
Please.
Okay.
I would like that.
I'll do it. So my grandma was hit by a car, and Hiwat's car died. And
yeah,
I just want to say good for me, because it feels good to finally say some of the dead grandma jokes that I've been, you know, wanting to say. But it's too soon. Like, it's really too soon, so I haven't been saying it out loud to anyone. But, you know, I'm just a girly who loves dark humor. And
I'm still on that Lula Murray thing. I don't know. Now I'm just clicking random videos. I can't see dislikes at all. Which is interesting.
Can you see likes?
Turned off. So that kind of gives you.
Yeah.
On the official Walt Disney Studios Little Mermaid trailer, the comments are turned off. Just getting that much hate that they had to.
Interesting.
I remember that the dislikes were like in the millions.
Wow.
It was crazy.
That's insane.
Yeah. I feel bad for her. She must have been going through it. And you know what? Sorry to go back to
Rachel. No, it's fine. Go back.
But I remember when people were talking about her and they were saying why can't she just be grateful and humble for her role like Hallie was? Like, because Hallie's so, like, she was so bubbly and, like, insanely positive in all her interviews and stuff. And, like, that made me so mad to hear because, for one thing, they're just different people, first of all. Yeah. I don't think Hallie was being any more grateful than Rachel was. I think she just does her interviews differently and she talks differently and she's just a different person. Mm-hmm. And also, it just made me so upset because I was like, all these people are like switching up as if they were like, see, these are like the racist people. Like, they're like, I would support her in this role if she would just be like grateful like Hallie was. And for one thing, the same people who are saying that are not when Hallie was announced as Little Mermaid, they're the same people who were hating on her for that because they didn't want a black girl as Little Mermaid.
Yeah.
And for two, the reason that Hallie has to be so, not saying that that's not genuine to her, but she literally has to be so nice and perfect and polite in all her interviews and everything she does, especially at that time, because she's already getting so much hate. So she's going to get scrutinized as being like an aggressive black woman if she has even slight of an attitude or a slight sense of humor or anything. Mm-hmm. And to like compare Rachel to her and be like, see, you should have been like her. It's like, that's so unfair because she already had to overcompensate and you're trying to police like women of color's behavior by comparing them and pitting them against each other. That just made me so upset. Anyways.
I guess, like, it's just really pathetic because everyone can just watch the originals. Everyone can enjoy what they were. But at the end of the day, it's 2023. Things are changing. Things have been changing. If you don't like a fucking movie because you're racist, then don't fucking watch the movie, racist asshole. Just move on.
Right. And who's riding so hard for Snow White?
Who? Because last time I checked,
like hardcore fans.
Last time I checked, she's the most unpopular.
Who? Since when she's so popular?
Yeah.
No one gives a fuck about Snow White.
No one's ever given a fuck about Snow White. She's been sleeping this whole time.
Right. Exactly. You better hope that Rachel's version like brings some interestingness to her, because it's giving boring. It's giving blasé, forgotten, nobody cared about. And like, now suddenly she has all these ride or die fans.
Okay. Like, I'm just confused. I don't even remember the original Snow White, okay?
Right.
Like, I'm confused. Is she sleeping most of the movie?
I don't know, because she bites the apple. It's the apple, right?
Yeah, I think so, yes. It's like Maleficent.
Doesn't one of the princesses prick their finger on something? Which one's that?
Oh.
That might be Snow White, right?
There's no way she pricks her finger and eats an apple.
I think it has to be the apple. Snow White is definitely the apple girl.
Who pricks their finger? Are you a Disney girl?
I'm not a
Disney girl, right?
I kind of am, but like the princess is not really. I'm sure I was into them when I was younger, but I don't really remember.
I was really into them when I was younger. I was never like a Disney girl, but I don't remember anything. Who pricks their finger? Okay,
someone
who
does, right? Though I'm not making that up.
No, you're not. Who are the Disney princesses? Who's Cinderella? Aurora? Aurora pricks her finger. Or does she eat the apple?
No, Snow White definitely eats the apple.
Okay, Aurora is blonde with the pink dress. Pink dress. Blonde pink dress. Snow White? Is her dress blue? I think her dress is blue.
Yeah, it has to be blue.
Yeah, Aurora must prick her finger then. No, Aurora's mirror on the wall.
Is that Snow White?
No, is that Snow White? Are these the same?
I think it's Snow White is mirror on the wall.
Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who's the fairest of them all?
I'm
yeah.
Basing this all off of?
What? Of what?
Once Upon a Time. Did you watch the show?
No.
Okay, well, I did a couple times.
Okay.
And the main, one of the main characters is Snow White.
Okay.
And the main antagonist is her op. And I recall the apple was in the story, kind of, I think. And I'm pretty sure that that main antagonist had the mirror. She had her magic mirror. And so I'm pretty sure that the mirror and the apple are Snow White's story.
Okay. Well, Maleficent.
Maleficent.
Is Snow White. Not is Snow White. Is in what? Snow White. Is in Snow White. She's the bad person.
I thought the evil queen was in Snow White.
No, I swear it was Maleficent.
Who's Aurora?
I don't know.
I know the name, but like...
Google it, please.
Oh, my God. Because, like, the name Aurora seems like a... That's her name, but, like, what's her princess name, you know?
It
like,
is Aurora. Is Aurora? Oh, what movie is Aurora?
That's what I mean. Because I'm just like, there's no movie called Aurora. So what movie is hers? Aurora.
Princess and the Frog? No.
No, no. Aurora. The Aurora. Oh, that's not. Princess.
This is infuriating.
Aurora is the pink dress.
Yes, that's what I said.
And.
Blonde, pink dress. Guys, if you know these Disney princesses, leave a comment. What did you say? Me? No, what did you say?
Sleeping Beauty.
Sleeping Beauty.
I can't believe I forgot that.
So, Aurora is Sleeping Beauty. So, she's sleeping the whole time. She pricks her finger, she sleeps. Yeah. So then what is Snow White?
Snow White eats the apple.
And falls asleep?
And sleeps. And I think if I had to take a wild guess... I think they both get awoken by True Love's kiss.
Okay, so the difference is that one has dark hair and a blue dress, and one has blonde hair and exactly, a pink dress. Yes. So no wonder we thought it was the same movie.
Right, y'all just made the same movie. You tried to pretend.
But you just said, guys, what if instead of an apple, she pricks her finger? And the room went wild. Wild. That's insane. We could write a movie like that.
You know what? We didn't. What I always think?
What?
People are like, ugh, movies aren't good anymore, whatever. To be fair, it wasn't as hard to make a good movie back then because the easy ideas to think of weren't taken yet.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
And like, same thing with music.
Exactly. It's like, of course you made a good song in the 20s.
There was like no music then.
Like, yeah. You had all the options. Now everyone has to be so creative because there's all the options are taken.
Like, no wonder I'm an alien is the song now.
I'm an alien.
I'm an alien. It's because, like, what else is there to sing?
Exactly. Like, let's just relax on these people. It takes time.
It takes time.
Everyone's doing the best.
We can't, like... all be so creative.
Right. Like, I feel like the amount of times people think of something and then they look it up and it's been made exactly as they thought before. It's
mm-hmm.
okay.
Mm-hmm. Like, I mean, how many times?
It's so much harder now.
How many times do I come up with an idea, tell you, and you're like, that's so good. I think it's already a thing.
Yeah. So many times.
All the time.
That's really good. Almost as if I've heard it before.
Yeah. Almost as if I've seen it. Yeah. Just like there's another Freaky Friday movie with, I think it's the girl from Wednesday and Jennifer.
I just saw that.
Garner.
Yeah. Jennifer Garner.
And all the comments were like, how original. It's like, bitch, every movie has ever been made already.
That's why when people complain about remakes, I'm like, okay, guys, I get it. I do get it. Like all these live actions. I understand we want new shit, but like. Why mess with what works, you know? I understand. If I was Disney, I would be making every remake too.
And, like, also, everyone's like, I love this movie. There's no movies that are as good as the ones in the past. So then you try to get the movies that were made in the past remade now. And you're like, fuck those movies. You can't remake them. Like, right. You can't do it as good.
Everyone has such an attachment to what they've already seen that they're like, it's just not as good as that other thing. But isn't it, though?
Yeah.
Isn't it, though? Because let's be real for a second. If you took that thing that you love so much that was made in the 90s and you made it right now just as it is, would it be hitting the same? I don't know. I don't know. By I don't know, I mean no, it would not, but I don't want to get in trouble.
Yeah. Like, y'all just have to realize it's a tough world out here for us creative people. And all the people hating don't get it. So just shut your mouth.
Just shut your mouth. It's free.
At the end of the day, it's easier to shut the fuck up. So just do it.
Mm-hmm. Unless, of course, you're me or you.
100%.
We can say whatever we want.
100%. Unless you have a podcast, you can shut your mouth. But if you have one, say whatever you want. Also, there's someone in my family who asked to be on the podcast.
Oh, who?
My uncle.
Which one?
Joe.
Oh.
And
it's not fun. It's funny.
I said, well, what would we talk about? And he goes, like, I would figure that out. And I go, okay. Oh. And then he goes, I have a perfect title for it. And this made me laugh. Are you ready to hear it?
I'm ready.
His idea. Okay. I don't care with Alexia DiStefano, but Joe DiStefano does care.
You know what? That's kind of funny. Like, that's too many words, but that idea, that's funny.
Yeah, it was so funny.
I do care with Joe DiStefano.
Yeah. I kept trying to explain that, like, the podcast is called I Don't Care, not the episodes.
Right, yeah, that's a little much, but, like, yeah, just name the episode, just, like, Joe Cares.
Joe Cares.
Caring with Joe DiStefano.
That's so funny.
That is kind of funny.
Yeah. I don't know what we would talk about, though. Probably, he would probably want to talk about, like, people on Main Street.
Why?
Like, their sobriety, how there's not enough housing for homeless people.
That's a good topic. It's true.
It is. So,
does he listen to your podcast?
He does.
And he likes it?
I think. I mean, he's always said nice things about it.
Okay.
So that's nice. I think he doesn't hate it. I don't think he listens to every episode because he said he didn't.
I don't think he listens to every episode. Mostly because he explicitly told me he never listens to every episode.
No, he listens more than you do, Hewat.
And that's just not a tough bar to get over.
It's not a tough bar. Tomorrow I have my grandma's viewing.
Oh, is it the first time?
It's going to be the first time I'm seeing her.
Wow, that's crazy.
It is.
Done up properly, or?
Yeah, they did say that her whole left side is scraped.
Really? It was that bad?
Well, she did die.
I know, but, like, she's old.
Yeah.
I assume it's easier to, like, shake up the innards when of an old person.
I didn't tell you it was a truck.
Like, no?
A company truck.
No.
I'm sorry. It's a company truck.
Oh, yeah. That makes more sense, I guess. Did she... Maybe this is too much, but did she go over or did she...
We don't know.
Oh, okay.
We think under.
Oh, you think she just ran over?
They said they didn't feel her, which is just bullshit. Oh, yeah.
Oh, you didn't tell me that either.
Okay, sorry. Okay, hi everyone. Let me update you. So the police have explicitly told us nothing. Everything I know, just to be crystal clear, is hearsay from other people who have heard something from someone who's heard something. Just to be clear.
Unreliable to me.
It's all we've got. So, it was a company vehicle. What company? I don't know. I can confirm it was a white truck. That was in a police report I read. They have over 200 angles of footage. Now, they have not explicitly said that it is a hit and run. However, she was hit and they did run.
And hey, I'm no expert. But, I'm no expert. I'm no detective, and you can quote me on that.
Mm-hmm.
But if, from my understanding, those are the only qualifications.
Those are. And so I don't know why they're not calling it a hit and run, but I can say when a police phone call was being made to a family member, they said, well, he did come back and he is cooperating now.
Who said that?
A police officer.
Okay.
I'm sorry. You just have to kill someone, but then be nice to the cops and you can go home?
That's absurd.
Like
what?
What?
Did they not know someone died?
Yeah, they know. They're the cops.
Like he damaged someone's property or something.
It's insane. I also have his name, which I won't say on the podcast. But the police report that I read did say his name.
Can you send it to me? Because I want to look him up.
I can't find him anywhere. But I think the name will kind of make you laugh a little bit. I'm writing it, guys. You guys can find it out one day. I just don't want to say something that, like, might interfere with the investigation. And they did specifically give the family this information, and it's not public, so I don't want to be the one to make it public.
Do you know how old he is, like, roughly?
No idea. Okay, based on his name, which don't say it out loud, what do you think he looks like?
He gives me, I would imagine he's like 35. Mm. He's like white, kind of like bulky, like you know the big guys in the football team?
Mm-hmm.
Like that kind of thing. Black hair, like scruffy, unkempt. That's what he gives.
Mm.
Am I right?
I don't know. I don't know what he looks like.
You don't know what he looks like.
To me, he's fat, dirty blonde, fair skin, a little musty. Yeah. He could be the hottest person on the planet.
I doubt it.
I do too. There is an actor in Vancouver with two of those names, just in a different order. I don't know if, like, I don't think that's him, and I hope it's not him, because he looks really nice, and, like, he's an actor.
Which one? Which parts of the name?
The second and the first are switched.
Oh. Probably not. That sounds like a separate name.
It does, right? So, but, like, we don't have really any more information than that. We know that, yeah, that whole side of her face was, or sorry, the whole side of her body was just, like, scraped up, which means she could have been dragged. We don't know. Like, we don't know anything. And
dragged?
Yeah. Like, yeah. Like, we don't know anything. But I do know one thing in my heart. If you drive over someone and hit someone with your fucking vehicle, you have to notice, unless you are high on fucking drugs, drunk, or like fucking asleep. I'm sorry. If you are going over someone who is not skinny, first of all, you have to notice that you have hit a bump.
There's no way. They have to be lying to, like, cover their ass.
And you fled.
There's literally no, like, that's impossible. You can't run over a human being and say you didn't feel it. Mm-hmm. You didn't know it was a person. You felt something big enough that is worthy of stopping for.
And check. In the middle of Hastings, there are no speed bumps on Hastings. Like, if you go over a bump, a big fucking bump.
Right.
Any human would stop to check what that is. Unless, again, you're so intoxicated, you didn't notice because you're intoxicated.
Yeah. I honestly think that they're lying. Because there's just no way. And they probably freaked out, drove off, and then now that it's so obviously you're going to get caught. Are you out of your mind? It was the middle of the day on Hastings.
11 in the morning, a beautiful sunny day.
Yeah, there's like, obviously you're going to get caught. So they got caught, and they're like, the only way to like save like my ass is to like say that I didn't feel it. Because even though that's unbelievable, it's a way to like kind of exonerate yourself. You know what I mean? Because it's like, I just didn't feel it.
Yeah.
You know? I couldn't have done anything because I didn't feel it.
Mm-hmm.
But there's no way. You can't not feel it. What are you talking about?
I know. Even a semi, like a big semi truck would feel it. I don't know. All right, friends. The card is full and I've deleted everything except this episode on here. So we're just going to wrap up what we're saying and close off this episode. So, yes, I love dark humor. I can joke around about tragedies that have occurred in my own life. But at the end of the day, I am fresh off the boat of mourning. This tragedy has affected my family terribly. Her funeral is Thursday. I'm not looking forward to it because it's a funeral. I'm very, very sad and upset by everything that's going on. She did not deserve it. She still had lots of life to live. She was only 70 years old when it happened, which, yes, is old, but, like, not old. Like, she still had, like, good time to live. And my family, we're all going through a lot. There's a lot of behind-the-scenes things that we're dealing with on top of everything, and it just sucks. So don't get mad at me if, you know, I say a joke or two. That's how I've always been. You guys know my dead dad jokes. And yeah, it's been 11 years and this has been a week and a half. But it is what it is. We all mourn and deal differently. So don't come at me. How do you feel, Hiwat?
Yeah, like same.
Period. Let's not bully people for just expressing their feelings.
Period.
And that's to Rachel. Because she deserves love.
She sure does. And Rachel, if you ever hear this, we love and adore you.
We love and adore you. And if you're ever writing a movie, hey, I'm Alexia DiStefano, 5 feet tall, based in Vancouver, British Columbia. And this is...
And I don't care. The podcast with Alexia DiStefano.
No, this is when you're supposed to do your slate.
I'm Hiwat Chadla, I'm 5'5", based in Vancouver.
Like, there's no way you thought I was ending with telling them I'm based in Vancouver and 5 feet tall.
No, I thought you were, like, just taking a dramatic pause before you said the name of the podcast or something. I don't know.
Oh, no. All right, everyone, until next week. Bye. Wow.